Welcome back to Wild Science with HEB. In our Beneficial Beaks episode, we discussed structural adaptation. Just to recap, adaptation is when an organism's structure or behavior changes to become better suited to survive and reproduce in its environment. It's a process that happens very slowly over many generations. In this episode, we are going to focus on behavioral adaptation, which is a behavior that increases an animal's chance of survival. There are two different types of behavioral adaptation: learned behavior and instinctive behavior.
What is learned behavior?
Learned behavior is taught and passed on from one generation to another. It is often learned at an early age by watching and copying others. Have you ever wondered why animals behave a certain way? Well, just like humans, animals have to learn how to do certain things to help them survive. Vocal mimicry, which is common amongst some birds, is an example of a learned behavior. Parrots are considered to be experts when it comes to vocal mimicry.
Hi, I am Eli Blanco. What is vocal mimicry?
Vocal mimicry is the imitation of all types of sounds, such as sounds made by other animals, humans, or even the environment. Let's meet Paige, a yellow-headed Amazon parrot that lives here at the Gladys Porter Zoo. She's an expert in vocal mimicry and can help us understand why an animal learns to mimic other birds or even humans to survive. In the wild, this brightly colored parrot can be found from Mexico to Central America. It is very difficult for a lone parrot to survive on its own because it is unable to search for food and look out for predators at the same time. That's why they live in large flocks that consist of several hundred birds, which requires them to communicate. Parrots are highly intelligent and are vocal learners. One yellow-headed Amazon was recorded to have learned around 100 words, 50 objects, 7 colors, 6 shapes, and was able to learn and repeat concepts. They learn sounds by listening and imitating them. Their ability to communicate is what enables them to survive and reproduce. The mastery of vocal mimicry requires good hearing, memory, and muscle control. Parrots that are successful at this skill will likely attract potential mates. It also helps them fit in with the flock, as well as share important information with other birds in their flock, especially when they feel threatened. This next animal is very intelligent and has been known to use several learned behaviors to survive. The common chimpanzee can be found in Central and West Africa. They are social animals that live in a complex social structure. Chimpanzees have displayed up to 39 learned behaviors, which include feeding, mating, grooming, and most notably, tool use. Their use of tools was first discovered by Jane Goodall, a primatologist who was studying chimpanzees in the Gombe National Park in Tanzania. She observed two chimpanzees take twigs and insert them into a termite nest. This allows the termites to climb on the twig. The chimps then eat the termites right off the twig. These behaviors are learned by watching one another. It has also been noted that the mothers will teach their young certain behaviors, especially grooming. Now let's concentrate on another aspect of behavioral adaptation, which is known as instinctive behavior.
Hello, my name is Javier Bailly. My question is, what is instinctive behavior?
An instinctive behavior is an innate pattern of behavior that is characteristic of a species and is often a response to specific environmental stimuli. It comes naturally to animals when they are born. It is inherited and not learned. Let's examine some animals that use their instinctive behaviors to survive in their environment. Cape hunting dogs, which are carnivores that live in East and South Africa, are very social animals that live in large groups and are excellent hunters. Are perfect examples of instinctive behavior.
What are social animals?
Social animals are those which interact highly with other animals, usually of their own species, to the point of having a recognizable and distinct society. Cape hunting dogs instinctively know that they must live in a group called a pack to survive. It is easier to ward off predators and other packs as a group. They scent mark by urinating to define and protect their territory. They also hunt in packs of 6 to 20 and sometimes more to ensure success. Since they don't have big, powerful jaws like cats, it is harder for them to take down large animals alone. Hunting in a pack is necessary because it allows them to bring down animals 5 times their size. With an impressive 80% success rate in hunting, wild dogs are among Africa's most effective predators. Solitary living and hunting is very rare in this species. They literally live and die for their family. They are even known to share food and assist weak or ill members of the pack. Being social and hunting are not the only instinctive behaviors animals use to survive. There are many more, including a very common behavior known as migration.
What is migration?
Migration is a seasonal movement of animals from one region to another. Many birds migrate to increase their chances of survival. It is assumed that the two main reasons for migration is to find food and to breed. They move from areas with minimal resources to areas of abundant or increasing resources. The sandhill cranes are found scattered in North America. Each winter, they migrate from their nesting grounds that are located as far north as Siberia to wintering grounds in Florida, Texas, Utah, Mexico, and California. On their way back north after winter, more than 500,000 sandhill cranes meet each spring at the Platte River Basin in Nebraska to rest and fuel up to finish their migration. It is considered to be one of the greatest wildlife phenomena in the United States. Well, thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Wild Science with HEB, and make sure to share it with your friends and family.